write me down in history with your bitter, twisted lies. You may tread me in the very dirt, but still, like dust, I rise. Does my sassiness upset you? Why are you beset with gloom? 'Cause I walk like I've got oil wells pumping in my living room. Just like moons and like suns, with the certainty of tides, just like hope springs high, still I rise. Did you want to see me broken? Bowed head and lowered eyes, shoulders falling down like raindrops, weakened by my soulful cries. Does my haughtiness offend you? Don't you take it awful hard, 'cause I laugh like I've got gold mines digging in my own backyard. You may shoot me with your words, you may cut me with your eyes, you may kill me with your hatefulness, but still, like air, I rise. Does my sexiness upset you? Does it come as a surprise that I dance like I've got diamonds at the meeting of my thighs? Out of huts of history's shame, I rise. Up from the past that's rooted in pain, I rise. I'm a black ocean, leaping and wide, welling and swelling, I bear the tide. Leaving behind nights of fear and terror, I rise. Into a daybreak that's wonderfully clear, I rise. Bringing the gifts that my ancestors gave, I am the dream and the hope of the slave. I rise, I rise, I rise. Let me start by saying good afternoon to our staff, honored guests, families and friends, but most importantly, to the class of 2020. I am excited to share with them and you, their families and friends, the end of a journey. A journey that has ended in great accomplishment. Keeping in mind that this is but one journey, because when this one ends, a new journey will begin. And I have no doubt, as they have shown me before, that they will rise to the occasion. Today we honor scholars who have persevered in the face of adversity, students who have proven, most importantly to themselves, that their goals are obtainable and that nothing is out of their reach. For not even the looming effects of an ongoing global pandemic could deter them from getting to this point in time. Today we share in our enthusiasm as we look to celebrate the accomplishments of our students from all over the District of Columbia, of different backgrounds, different races, and different cultures, who have at least one commonality that will bind them for the rest of their lives. And that commonality is that at the end of today, they will be graduates of the Roosevelt STAY Opportunity Academy class of 2020. Thank you for being here, and we thank you for sharing in their accomplishment.
Please stand for the presentation of colors and the national anthem. Thank you. Next, we will have a welcome address by our salutatorian, Ms. Oluwakemi Okafor.
Good afternoon, students, teachers, parents, and friends. I would like to thank you from teachers to friends and families for being in attendance this afternoon. You have had a great influence on the student that will be graduating today, and I am excited to be speaking on behalf of the whole graduating class of 2020. Throughout the months I've been in Roosevelt State Opportunity Academy, I have gained not only knowledge of the subject I have studied, but also many other lessons as well. People who question or have questioned the need to attend classes, but gaining intelligence is not the purpose of it all. School has helped to build priceless social skills. If you believe you can achieve anything and do not allow others to tell you a different thing, what you are capable of doing is truly amazing. I've also had the opportunity to spend time with amazing and inspiring teachers, staffs, and counselors. These people have helped not only me, but all students to achieve the best of their ability, and I appreciate and commend them. Despite the COVID pandemic, we are all able to push through regardless of the situation we are living in, and we successfully completed our academic school year. Although we had no problem, we are still able to graduate virtually. My advice not only goes for the graduating students, but to those who are going to graduate later on. Never give up. If you at any point you feel the urge to give up, please don't. Keep pushing through. It won't be easy, but still push and push to the point where you say, I did it. And also, do not let the anxieties of life weigh you down. The risks are always present, but you will learn from the mistake you make, and you'll be able to stand up through that experience. Thank you all again for participating in our virtual graduation and giving us tremendous support that made us grow to step out to another place. Thank you. Congratulations, class of 2020. We did it! We shared it.
And now, a musical selection dedicated to the class of 2020.
Hey everybody, it's singer-songwriter Asia Bello, and I just wanted to congratulate the 2020 graduating class of Roosevelt STAY. You guys have worked so hard all year, and this is a really exciting time. I know that there's so much going on in the world right now, but we need your voices, we need your minds, we need your gifts and your talents to help make a better future, not just for us, but for the next generation. So I'm very excited for you guys, and I hope that you'll continue to push, continue to fight, and continue to win. And I hope that this song will inspire you to continue to create and do what you can do, what only you can do with your gift to make this world a better place. Congratulations, class of 2020.
Sometimes it don't go your way. Sometimes you gotta. Sometimes. Sometimes it don't go your way. Sometimes. You gotta. Yeah. I had a plan. I had it mapped out. I knew where I was going when I left out. Oh, and you couldn't tell me that I wouldn't be there on time. I had some guarantees, I had a deadline. Oh, but now things change for better or worse. You could say that I'm the same, but I ain't adjusted to the hurt. Oh, so many no's, so many yeses. No one to blame, I got the answers. I felt the pain, I can't attest it. That's just the game, I can't respect it. Cause sometimes it don't go your way. Sometimes. And sometimes you gon' have those days, yeah. And sometimes you'll feel out of place. And you can't promise me it'll be the same. Cause sometimes change, yeah. Sometimes change, yeah. I had a date, I had a vision. This was the day I was supposed to be living. Instead of worrying about the temporary things, I hate not knowing where it's gonna take me. Oh, so many no's, so many yeses. Oh, I was sure, but now I'm guessing. Feel like my faith keep getting tested. I need a sign, I need a message. Cause sometimes it don't go your way. Sometimes. And sometimes you gon' have those days, yeah. And sometimes you'll feel out of place. No, you can't promise me it'll be the same. Cause sometimes change, sometimes change, sometimes you. Sometimes change, you gotta know, things gon' change. Cause sometimes it don't go your way. Sometimes, oh, sometimes you gon' have those days. Oh, and sometimes you feel out of place. And you can't promise me it'll be the same. Cause sometimes change, yeah, yeah. Sometimes change.
And now, a few words from our mayor, Muriel Bowser, our chancellor, Dr. Louis Ferriby, and our valedictorian, Matuos Tedes.
Hello, graduates and families. On behalf of our entire community, I want to congratulate the class of 2020. I know this is not the graduation or senior year you expected, but do not let that take away from how proud you should feel in this moment. That goes to for parents and grandparents, aunts and uncles, teachers and coaches, and everyone else watching who helped to make today possible. Class of 2020, you are graduating high school at a time when your voices are needed more than ever. Our nation is hungry for change. The pandemic set the stage for creating a new normal, and the recent protests and demands for justice have made clear just how necessary a new normal is. As cities across the country, including our own, begin to reopen, people don't want to go back to how things used to be. People want a world that is better than before, more equal and more just than before. Starting right now, you have a once-in-a-generation opportunity to rebuild and reimagine our societies. You are ready for this moment. Your generation grew up in a world that is constantly changing, so you are undaunted by the unknown. And not just undaunted, but excited. You are ready to root out injustice in all its forms, ready to achieve statehood for Washington, D.C. Class of 2020, you are ready to shake things up and build the more inclusive America we know is possible. So congratulations, stay safe, stay healthy, and stay ready to make a change.
Greetings to the Class of 2020 graduates, families, and our entire DC Public Schools community. It has been my pleasure to be a part of our students' journeys as they look to become business leaders, digital designers, medical professionals, and yes, school teachers. And while I only got to know our graduating class most recently as chancellor, I recognize the unique experiences of being a DCPS graduate that it brings into the world. This class of 2020. After all, I urge you to take this time to reflect on what it means to grow up in our nation's capital, to embrace the bonds of our community, and to enter each day being your true self. To the class of 2020, you were born in the early days of a new millennium. Let that sink in for a minute. You are one in a thousand. For each generation of DCPS graduates growing up in Washington, D.C., it gives you a front row seat to the daily headlines and trending topics. You have heard these stories from your grandparents, your teachers, your neighbors, but now it's time to tell your story as the class of 2020. You will be able to say things like, I recited poetry from the steps of the Lincoln Memorial. I helped make the Anacostia River cleaner for people and animals. I danced the go-go at homecoming all night long. I attended a mock trial at the United States Supreme Court. I started my school's first vegetable garden with First Lady Michelle Obama. I ate a half smoke from the famous Ben's Chili Bowl. I raised awareness of gun violence, climate change, and immigrant rights and social justice. I shook hands with President Barack Obama, and I marched peacefully in my city to protest against police brutality and walk down Black Lives Matter Plaza. Your story is about our hallways and our sidewalks in your school. It's about cheering so loud at the turkey bowl that your voice goes hoarse. It's about the inside jokes between you and your closest friends. It's about balancing school, job, family, all the commitments that you have, but yet and still maintaining good grades and still remembering those that are no longer with us. You did what many cannot do, and while this year did not turn out as we predicted, one thing we know for certain is you work hard and it will not go unnoticed. We're not celebrating you in person today, but we are still celebrating you. DC Public Schools is proud of our graduates, and we know you will go on to accomplish things that we cannot even think of in this moment. It is why the class of 2020 will be the very first DCPS Persist class, as a new program is being launched to provide graduates with special resources that will be available to them as they begin the next chapter. We want every DCPS student who goes on to college to have the support and the guidance they need to succeed as they earn their degree and pursue their path of a fulfilling career. You are entering the world as a DCPS alumni, and we hope that your successes become a source of inspiration for future graduates. I cannot wait to hear what you have to say, to see what you are doing, and experience what you are creating. To the class of 2020, I salute you on behalf of the entire DCPS school community. We all say, congratulations, class of 2020.
Good afternoon, my fellow students, educators, and school staff. My name is Matthew Siminda. As the valedictorian, I'm standing here wishing I was able to physically celebrate in the auditory room with all of you. But all is not lost, because I am going to be able to celebrate with my classmates, the amazing class of 2020. My journey, like many of you, has not always been easy. I moved to the United States in about 5 years ago. Before moving here, I was always traveling and performing in many countries and continents. Life separated me from my family and taught me how to be independent. Even with that independence, I had moments where I felt uncertain. By the show of hands or thinking to yourself, answer these questions. How many of you had a goal that felt too far to reach? How many of you had moments where you doubted yourself or wanted to give up? How many of you have had a moment where responsibilities outside of school seem larger than coming to class? Well, I have a news for you, class of 2020. Despite those moments of feeling overwhelmed, you are still standing. You're standing confident, strong, and focused. You have found a way to overcome obstacles and achieve the ultimate goal of becoming a 2020 graduate of Roosevelt STAY High School. When looking at your peers in this room, we all have different stories, some that we know about and some that we have not heard. But we do have one thing in common, and that is we stay ready. My story started in the capital city of Ethiopia, Addis Ababa, where I was born and raised. For those of you who don't know, it's located in the Horn of Africa. It is the only African country that was never been colonized by any European country. It is also the only country that have its own alphabets and calendar. So if you want to go back in time, just know you can go to Ethiopia because it's currently 2012 in there. Ethiopia is beautiful and it represents the untold African history. Growing up, my parents had a very low income and we financially struggled most of my life. Since I was six, I was always trying to find ways to make money so I could support my family. I would often skip school and do shoe shining on the streets. Suddenly, one year, as a summer program, I joined the circus. I practiced for about 5 years, and finally, at the age of 12, I got the chance to travel all across the globe performing and competing on global circus stages. Although exploring the world and making money at the same time was amazing, I often found myself being lost in the world and missing my family a lot. Nevertheless, it taught me how to preserve, be organized, and develop with both resilience and tenacity. When I moved to the United States, I had nobody to depend on or no idea how I was going to become successful. But I knew whatever it took, I was ready to give it my all because I had nothing to lose. After moving here, I started going to school and working two jobs to be able to pay my bills. I took 18 classes in 1 year while working, providing for my family back home and providing for myself. It was one of the hardest times for me. Last summer, I had the privilege to attend Peer Forward training camp in Washington College. I remember thinking, how in the world am I going to afford college and pursue my dream? I felt as if working hard was not close to being enough. I doubted if I was ever good enough to be able to form a life that I could enjoy. Like all of you, I stayed focused even when I doubted myself. I stayed focused when I had people tell me I couldn't get what I want. When you come from a very low-income family in Africa, everybody talks down to you. But we know the song, Something to Prove by Lil Baby. They don't want to see us on TV unless it's the news, I got something to prove. So this year, I became the first student to ever receive the Posse Foundation Scholarship in our school. So yes, I proved, especially to myself, that I can follow through my dreams. A wise man once said, talent is overrated, but persistence is undefeated. Do what you need to do in life. Know what you want, know what you feel like, but what you need. Separate your needs and focus on those instead of wasting your time on frivolous interests. Invest your time on assets and have faith in yourself. You will succeed just like you have now. Sometimes in life, people might express negative thoughts or biases towards you. They might judge you based on your skin color, religion, or sexuality before they even know you. Remember the rich history and culture that you come from and uphold your honor in your community and family strength. The people that doubted or judge you do not realize that right now is the only beginning of your greatness shines bright for the future. From this point on, we can climb further, use our voice, use our talents, and use our motivation to be leaders. Class of 2020, if there is anything that we can see right now is that we believe in ourselves. Even though our stories might have moments where we overcome obstacles, they're also filled with celebrations, powers, and joy. Don't limit yourself in thinking that you cannot achieve your goals. Everything is possible. You have already proven that yourself. When you look inside yourself, you'll find power that lives in you and keep growing. Congratulations, class of 2020. We made it to the first stop, and now we will keep going. The marathon continues. I will now introduce our guest speaker, Principal Baritu Kafele. Principal Baritu Kafele, a highly regarded urban educator in New Jersey for more than 20 years, has distinguished himself as a master teacher and a transformational school educator. As an elementary school teacher in East Orange, New Jersey, Principal Kafele was named the East Orange School District and Essex County Public School Teacher of the Year. Principal Kafele was a finalist for the New Jersey State Teachers of the Year Award and recipient of the New Jersey Educational Association Award of Excellence. As a middle school and high school principal, Principal Kafele conducted the transformation of 4 New Jersey urban schools. His educational leadership led the mighty Newark Tech to grow from the lowest performing school to the nation recognition. The school was recognized 3 times by the U.S. News and World Report as one of the America's best high schools. As renowned school leadership experts and educational speaker in America, Principal Cafella is impacting American schools. He has delivered over 2,000 conference and programs, keynotes, transformational development workshops, parenting seminars, and student assemblies over his 34 years of public speaking. As an expert in the area of attitude transformation, Principal Cafella is the leading authority of providing effect classrooms and school leadership strategies towards closing what he coined as the attitude gap. He is the author of 11 books, including his 6 national bestsellers, Closing the Attitude Gap, Motivating Black Males to Achieve in School and in Life, The Teacher 50, In My School, Is My School a Better School Because I Led It, the Principal 50, and the Aspiring Principal 50. His latest book, The Assistant Principal 50, was released in May 2020. Principal Cafella is the recipient of more than 150 educational, professional, and community awards. This awards includes the prestigious Milken National Educator Award and National Alliance of Black School Educators Hall of Fame Award. He has indicated into the East Orange, New Jersey Hall of Fame in the city of Dixon, in Texas, proclaimed on February 8, 1998, to be Baruch Cafella's Day.
Greetings. This is Principal Cafella. And first and foremost, I want to salute, I want to commend, I want to congratulate the Roosevelt STAY Opportunity Academy graduating class of 2020. Give yourselves a big round of applause. Look, I'm going to keep it real with you. I'm sitting here doing a commencement address on a computer. This is very awkward. It is very different. But this entire year has been very awkward. It's been very different. Just you having a graduation virtually is a different experience. See, we're in the midst of a global pandemic. Coronavirus. COVID-19, which creates all sorts of uncertainty relative to your next move, where you go from here after graduation. I get it, but I want to tell you this in the short time I'm going to speak to you. Despite these challenges, you're ready because you have experienced, you've endured challenges that nobody else has ever endured, not in this lifetime, where everything just came to a screeching halt. All schools across America just came to a halt. And those who had access to a computer, those who had access to Wi-Fi, they were able to resume their education to some extent, virtually, but it certainly wasn't what it was in the brick and mortar, in the school. So you had to endure some huge challenges that nobody conceptualized, but you got through it as evidenced by your graduation. So now you got to turn that corner and it's on to the next step. I understand that some of you are going on to college and others of you are going right into the workforce. So whatever it is, you're going to do it and you're going to do it at a high level. But you know, there's another distraction. Global pandemic was number one, but I'm recording this address on May 30th. And that means we're in the midst of social unrest. I know you've been keeping up with the news. I know you know what's going on out here in the world. We're in the midst of social unrest, which creates its own uncertainties moving forward because things are changing. I will not politicize my message, but I will say this to you in that context. In the midst of social unrest, you have got to play your part in ensuring that justice prevails for everybody. Each and every one of us has a responsibility, including myself. So I'm saying to you that as we move forward in life, when we talk about justice, justice doesn't come about out of the thin blue sky. It comes about because of individuals like yourself. So each and every one of us has a role to play. Each and every one of us has a responsibility. I'm saying to you, again, without politicizing my message, that you have to do your part. To just undo the uncertainty so that we understand, so that we see we're certain where we're headed. That's on you. But moving on, I think about my own high school graduation and the individual uncertainty that I had. I was elated to be at graduation, to be at my final day of K-12 education. I was elated. But on the other side, there was anxiety because I didn't know where I was going. I didn't know where I was headed because I did not necessarily have ambition of what the next stage would look like. I didn't know. I didn't necessarily have a dream at that time. I didn't necessarily have ambition at that time. So I'm saying to you, some of you who are listening to me right now, you may have a plan of action. You know exactly what it is you want to do and how you're going to get there. But there may be others listening who are just as confused as I was. And you're not clear, you're not certain on what tomorrow will bring. You don't know exactly if you want to move in this direction, this direction, this direction, or this direction. I get it. I understand because I was there. But I will help you to resolve it in this message. I'm saying to you, you got to set some goals. You got to set long-term goals and, more importantly, your short-term goals, which we call incremental goals. You got to set goals in terms of what it is that you're going to accomplish between right now, which we can call point A, and next week at this time. Between right now and next month at this time. Between right now and 6 months from now. Between right now and a year from now. What are those things that you will do as a staircase to get to where you're going? What are they? What are those goals? What are those things you must do to continue to climb the staircase toward ultimately achieving your goal? Well, toward filling in those spaces between one step to the next step is what you call your strategy, your plan, your blueprint for success. You got to write a plan or multiple plans, detailed plans, to tell you what you have to do. I don't do anything in life without goals and a plan. So therefore, I venture off to do something, but I got a plan on how I'm going to achieve it. So I'm saying to you, it works the same way with your lives. You got to write them goals, and then you got to formulate the plan, and then you've got to walk in the plan every day. That may require you to take a good look at yourself and assess you, assess your surroundings, assess who's in your space, and you might have to cut some folks loose because there may be some folks in your space who are moving in an opposite direction from the direction you must move in order for you to reach your goals, in order for you to maximize your potential, in order for you to live your dream. You may have to cut some folks loose. You may have to cut some things loose. You may have to cut some habits loose. Whatever it is, you may have to carve yourself out a new beginning. See, so that requires, once again, that you assess you, that you evaluate you, that you assess your surroundings, that you evaluate your own surroundings, and then you make some very tough, critical decisions as to how you're going to proceed. And again, that may be without some folks that have been with you for a long time. See, as we get older, those are the kinds of decisions that we have to make. Because your journey is not necessarily meant for other people to ride with you. That might be a solo journey, or it may be a journey for other passengers, but not necessarily the same ones that you have with you right now, as others may cut you loose. You've got to consider that as well, right? So a part of that is determining your why, though. You got to determine your purpose. What is your purpose for your life? And I'll be quite frank with you. A lot of us don't know. A lot of us can't answer that question. We just wake up in the morning, strive to get through the day, go to sleep at night, and then wake up tomorrow and do the same thing. Others of us have a bigger picture. And we say, I've got a purpose for my life. That's usually something very narrow. They say, I've got a reason. I've got a because. I've got a why to my existence. I'm asking you, what's your why? And will you strive to walk in your why? Your why is critical. So I said this is a short message, so let me leave you with five words and then I'm done. Take these words and just make them a part of you. I call them my five ingredients for success. Word number one, belief. And I'm saying to you, you've got to believe in yourself, even if there's no one else in the world out here that believes in you or your dream. You must believe in you. You must believe in your dream. Number two, purpose. You got to be about something. And you got to be about something bigger than yourself, as I said before, when we were talking about justice versus injustice. You got to be about more than just you. Purpose, your why. Number three, obligation. I'm saying to you that your success is non-negotiable. You have an obligation to be extraordinary. Number four, determination, which means you got to have the will, the drive, the passion. You've got to be on your grind, getting it done every day. And then the last word, vision. That means you got to see your success before you take the first step tomorrow. You got to see yourself in the driver's seat. You got to envision yourself doing that which you said you want to do. So again, belief, purpose, obligation, determination, and vision. Once again, to Roosevelt STAY Opportunity Academy, I salute you. I commend you. I applaud you. I congratulate you. I'll see you at another time in the winner's circle celebrating your success. Congratulations.
And now a musical selection dedicated to the class of 2020.
I can almost see that dream I'm dreaming, but there's a voice inside my head saying, you'll never reach it. Every step I'm taking, every move I make feels lost with no direction. My faith is shaking, but I gotta keep trying, gotta keep head held high, 'cause there's always gonna be another mountain. I'm always gonna wanna make it move. Always gonna be an uphill battle, and sometimes I'm gonna have to lose. It ain't about how fast I get there, it ain't about what's waiting on the other side. It's the climb. The struggles I'm facing, the chances I'm taking, sometimes might knock me down, but no, I'm not breaking. I may not know it, these are the moments that I'm gonna remember most, yeah. Just keep on going, and I gotta be strong, gotta keep pushing on, 'cause there's always gonna be another mountain. I'm always gonna wanna make it move. Always gonna be an uphill battle, but sometimes I'm gonna have to lose. It ain't about how fast I get there, it ain't about what's waiting on the other side. It's the climb. Waiting on the other side. It's the climb.
Class of 2020 Senior Awards. EDP Outstanding Scholar, given to an evening program student who has shown the most growth and improvement during their tenure at our stay. Trayon St. John. EDP Stellar Stallion Award, given to an evening program student who has exemplified the values and mission of our stay. Cynthia Gorham. Community Service Award, awarded to the student with the most community service hours in the graduating class. Angeline Hernandez. Most Improved, given to a student who has been in our stay for at least 2 years and has shown improvement in academics, behavior, and/or mindset during his, her, or their tenure at our stay. Daquan Odin. Outstanding ELL Scholar Award. A student who is or has been a member of the ELL program who has shown outstanding achievement in academics, leadership, and embodying our stay values. Samarwit Jeb Brahewit. Outstanding CTE Scholar Award, given to a student who has shown excellence in their area and shown promise to be a leader in the profession. Janine McGreer Douglas. Scholar Athlete of the Year, an athlete with the highest GPA. Joseph Romani. Citizenship Award, given to a student who represents our state values and mission. Miles Duncan. Leadership Award, given to a student who has demonstrated the qualities of a leader to include determination, organization, honesty, a willingness to help others, as well as academic success. Morgan Hicks. Principal's Award, given to a student with a top 10 GPA and the highest attendance. Joseph Romanu. Salutatorian, the student with the second highest GPA of the graduating class. Oluwakemi Okafor. Valedictorian, the highest ranking GPA of the graduating class. Matuos Tedesi.
And now a few encouraging words from the staff of Roosevelt STAY.
Congratulations, class of 2020. 2020 has defined itself as unprecedented, but despite all obstacles it has thrown your way, you have finally made it. You've accomplished your goal, and for that, you are now at the finish line. I hope that you maintain this same level of perseverance as you move forward. Stay ready, stay focused, wishing you all the best on your future endeavors.
Hey, our STAY family, it's Ms. Bradley. Congratulations, seniors, you did it. Want to give you some advice. If you're going to do anything in life, make sure that you do your best at it. And if you do not succeed, try again. Never, ever, ever think you cannot start over, because you can. Good luck, family.
Congratulations, Roosevelt STAY Class of 2020. You have overcome insurmountable odds to be here today. I salute your focus and perseverance and wish you all the best of luck. Congratulations.
Yo, congratulations, our STAY Class of 2020. You worked hard, you stayed strong, you deserve this. Enjoy it. Be blessed, have a great summer.
Hi, Roosevelt students. This is Ms. Eastman, and I am screaming, congratulations, class of 2020. You guys did it. May God continue to bless you on your journey, and I wish you all the best. Thank you. Bye.
Congratulations, class of 2020. You are very resilient, and we are very proud of you. Wishing you all the best for continued success in your next chapter.
Roosevelt STAY, class of 2020, congratulations. You guys have made it. You have shown
the world. You have shown their family, your friends, all of us here that you can persevere and accomplish anything you set your mind to. Just remember to always work hard, keep your eyes on your goals, and know that if you have the right people around you and belief in yourself, anything is possible. Congratulations.
Congratulations, class of 2020. I am so excited and proud of you. While we're virtually celebrating you, please know that we are still with you and so happy for you on this next part of your journey in life. I have two quotes. One, I want you to want it more than you're afraid of it. And that just means you have to dream big and go for it. Know that everything is open to you and available. While this pandemic is going on, it is still not stopping you from doing all that you want to do. And then two, music, like water, is necessary for life. So play your favorite song and dance and celebrate. Congratulations.
Hi, seniors. Happy graduation. Congratulations. We are so proud of you and cannot wait to see how you make this world a better place. I hope in all your adventures, you stay focused, stay humble, stay grounded, stay learning, and of course, stay ready. See you soon.
Congratulations, Roosevelt State Class of 2020. I'm so happy to share in the excitement of your graduation day and so very proud of each and every one of you. Please continue to push forward on your next endeavor, knowing that the Roosevelt State family is here for you forever. With love and pride, today and always, stay ready.
Congratulations, RSA seniors. Chasing a dream requires efforts, passion, and hard work. You are now in the halfway. Keep up your good work and continue to strive. Felicitaciones. El futuro pertenece a quienes creen en la belleza de sus sueños. The future belongs to those who believe in the beauty of their dreams. Felicidades.
Hello, graduation class of 2020. It's Ms. Mullins. I just wanted to say I'm happy and proud for you.
Roosevelt STAY seniors, I want to say congratulations, and I am so proud of you. You did it through all of this. And I want you to know it's okay for it not to be okay, because it will be. I love and miss you all, and I just want to hug you. Congratulations. Go out there and do whatever you want to do.
Hello, class of 2020. This is Ms. Reddick. All of you have shown that you have immense leadership skills to continuously evolve in changing circumstances. Celebrate your big wins and your small wins. I am so proud of you, and I cannot wait to celebrate with you on graduation day. Go, class of 2020.
Felicidades, graduandos. Congratulations, graduates. Les deseo todo lo mejor. I wish you the absolute best. Ciao.
Congratulations, Roosevelt STAY seniors, from me, Ms. Storks. As you walk across the stage virtually and accept your diplomas virtually, congratulations, and know that you have completed a huge challenge during these very weird times. As you go out into the world, I wish you nothing but the best, and I wish you nothing but power to use your voice and to use all that you have naturally and all that you've gained in your time of study. Congratulations.
I know we all had a vision for how 2020 was gonna turn out, and it probably didn't end up exactly how we thought. But even with everything going on, you still managed to find your way to the finish line, which means your future is bright. Congratulations to the class of 2020.
And now words from our educational leader, Principal Dwayne Little.
Thank you, Principal Caffelli, for your encouraging and inspiring words to the class of 2020. Before I begin, I would like to thank all of the parents, the guardians, step-parents, brothers and sisters, aunts and uncles that help you all get to this day. You would not be here without them, so thank you all for that. In addition, I would also, on behalf of the class of 2020, thank the senior class committee, as well as our counseling department, Ms. Hurt, Ms. Redding, and Ms. Aviles. Thank you all for your vision and your vitality and your enthusiasm to help get the class of 2020 to where they are today. In addition, I would also like to thank the amazing staff of Roosevelt STAY for your support and making sure that all our graduates have what they need and the skills they need to be successful and are here today. Class of 2020, you made it. You're here. I want to talk to you about your vision. about the ideas of attachment and detachment. We are often attached to things as we know them to be. The certainty of what we've known has always been there. It's familiar. It's there when we go to sleep, and it's there when we wake up. It's predictable. Detachment is a new way of thinking, allowing new opportunities, a new perspective, if you will. This kind of thinking is how you develop a vision for yourself and your future. Principal Cafele mentioned setting up a goal and making a plan for yourself, for your future, for where you would be 4 years from now and 4 years after that and on into the future. I ask you today to go into a state of detachment from old ways of thinking and acting. We are here in the middle of a pandemic as well as social unrest. These are uncertain times, very uncertain. When we have times of uncertainty, we have to be resilient. Each of you have demonstrated the ability to be resilient. You demonstrated resiliency when you walked in the doors of Roosevelt State. Each of you came in here overcoming one obstacle or another, day in and day out. Whether that was traveling to school, whether that was an obstacle in school, whether that was you trying to figure out and advocate for yourself. Each of those were all obstacles, and they're all understandable. And for that, you need to be commended, because you showed hard work and grit, and you persevered. That grit and perseverance is what will see you through the uncertain times that we live in, and those sure to come in the future. This is an opportunity for you to be an innovator, to demonstrate your creativity, to start something new. I recently heard that people were saying that 2020 is over. It's canceled, it's dead, it's a waste. Let's pretend it didn't happen. But what if we don't cancel 2020? I mean, how can we? You guys are the class of 2020, and you're here. You will be the class that the world remembers. You will be the one that goes down in history. So instead of hiding from uncertainty and confusion, what if you lean into it? In the class, there are some of you that are going to be our next inventors, our next innovators, our next engineers. Some of you in this class are going to find the cure for viruses and diseases of the future. This class right here will determine what our future will look like for years to come. You're going to be able to do all of this and more because you will be able to pull all the resources that you have tapped into during this time and has gotten you here, gotten you past, gotten you over, and gotten you through all the obstacles that have stood in front of you. In the past, it allowed you to develop the resiliency that has gotten you to this very moment. So I ask you to lean into the discomfort you are feeling. It's very uncomfortable right now, and I understand that. Get to know it, though, so when you face future obstacles, they will be a piece of cake, because you have already faced and overcome so much. You have the skills for this. You are a Roosevelt Stay Stout, and you stay ready. And when I say stay ready, I mean stay ready for people that are going to doubt you. Stay ready for a system that will ignore you or push you to the side. Stay ready for people that don't think the same way that you do. No one thought the same way Einstein thought. No one thought the same way Newton thought. No one thought the same way or had the same beliefs as Martin or Malcolm during their times. So stay ready, and stay ready to stand out, because that's what it's going to take. The world is looking for you to guide them in the future, because 2020 didn't just happen by chance. 2020 is all about vision. When people ask your vision, you say, it's 2020. I'm good to go. We're all good to go in 2020 because of you. We're here today to celebrate the class of 2020 and all your achievements and accomplishments. The class of 2020 has amassed over $700,000. I would be remiss to pause and acknowledge Diego Gonzalez. Diego has amassed over $300,000 in grants and scholarship money. Congratulations, Diego. For the first time, we have a Posse scholar, We have several Economic Club scholars, and we also have a Trachtenberg scholar. Your achievements have led to such institutions as the George Washington University, as well as Lafayette University, to name a couple. With that, I say congratulations to the class of 2020. It's credit to your hard work. Don't let anyone ever doubt you. You have persevered, you have demonstrated grit and resiliency, and continue to build as you move forward. Continue to move forward. The great Martin Luther King once said, if you cannot fly, then run. If you cannot run, then walk. If you cannot walk, then crawl. But whatever you do, just move forward. Class of 2020, you made it. This is your moment. Seize it and move forward.
And now, by the power vested in me, by the mayor of the District of Columbia, Muriel Bowser, and the chancellor of the District of Columbia Public Schools, Dr. Louis Farabee, I hereby certify that the 50 members of the class of 2020 have completed the requirements for graduation from Roosevelt STAY Opportunity Academy.
On behalf of Mayor Bowser and Chancellor Farabee, I enthusiastically accept the class of 2020 for Roosevelt STAY Opportunity Academy. Congratulations.
Kanaya Ayers, Brittany Baker, Diane Barber,
Caleb Bikele, Carla Castro Turcios,
Cindy Chen Yo, Devin Dickerson Diggs, Miles Duncan,
Marita Escobar, Jacqueline Flores Salmeron, Emily Flores, Talisha Foster,
Anonia Frazier,
Samrawit Jibrahiwit,
Maya Gilmore, Daviana Gonzalez,
Diego Gonzalez Portillo,
Cynthia Gorham, Trinity Hall, Kayeen Hill,
Angeline Hernandez,
Morgan Hicks,
Enrique Jefferson,
Melissa Jones,
Darwin Lopez,
Anthony Love,
Jennifer Maldonado, Juan Martinez,
Jamie McGreer Douglas, Delshawn Mitchell,
Christian Murquete,
Philip William Navarrete, Daquan Odin, Olowakimi Okafor,
Carlos Pereira, Gertrudis Perez Juarez, Anna Petrisic Tinto,
Toshia Pittman,
Joseph Romano, Vania Ramos,
Daniel Robinson, Claristine Silver,
Luis Sorto.
Trayon St. John.
Matos Tudes.
Jada Thompson.
Merari Tovar Martinez.
Doril Turner.
Jeremiah Turner.
Ariana Ventura Bonilla.
Kenyatta Wade.
Tremaine Warren.
Chantal Ziegler.
Congratulations!
I now present to you the class of 2020. Congratulations.
That little Chico Pitbull, Mr. 305, but it said Mr. Worldwide, and I'm checking in to speak to the graduating class of 2020.
Felicidades en su graduación, la clase de 2020.
Congratulations to the class of 2020.
Congratulations, Washington, D.C., class of 2020.
I want to, first of all, congratulate each and every one of you for obtaining such a monumental event in your lives.
I want to personally congratulate you on this great milestone you have achieved in your academic career.
Congratulations, class of 2020. Enjoy your day. Dance like you've never danced before. Make the most of this quarantine, because tomorrow the real work starts. Tomorrow the work of being a change agent and changing the world starts.
I just wanted to say how incredibly proud I am of every single one of you. This was not an easy year. And you continued and you pushed through.
You are the first and the freshest of graduates who will face down this pandemic and its aftermath. So pivot. Bring your ideas, energy, and urgency to bear upon this situation. Be leaders in helping us to address it and all the other challenges we face in the world.
We need your energy. We need your creativity. We need your courage and boldness. We need you to be willing to step out and to change the world, because the world is in dire need of change.
Ustedes son parte de una clase muy, muy especial. Esto viene siendo en 2020 la clase más histórico de todo el mundo.
When you get on campus, I want you to be a leader, okay? It's gonna be a lot of people in your way. I want you to keep a tight net bond with family and friends back home, and I want you to take it every day at a time, all right?
Go into your lives, go into your futures, stay focused, stay humble, stay loving.
I want y'all to continue to strive to be the best that you can be. I know this is some crazy times right now, but you got through it. You got through it.
I want to see you all become the next millionaires, the next billionaires, the next business owners. So hold it down for the District of Columbia. Keep moving forward. Never give up. And always think about what you overcame.
So I can't wait to see what the class of 2020 comes up with. We are watching. We are proud of you. We are so excited for you. And just go out there and kill it.
I know from witnessing the art you've created, the service projects you've already pioneered, and the level of civic engagement you've already demonstrated, that you as a class and as a generation coming to adulthood are going to be able to surmount the challenges that come your way.
The DC public school system is very, very special. You are a very special class, and I just want to wish you the best for your journey into the future.
Keep pursuing everything that you want. Make sure you guys reach for the stars, and make sure you guys understand that you guys are DC public school graduates. Yes, go DC public schools. DC public schools. Let's go.
God bless you. Congratulations. And stun on them. Stun on them. Stun on them. You're out. You made it.
Congratulations, DCPS class of 2020, on your graduation.
Wishing y'all the best for the future and hope y'all stay safe out there.
Congratulations again to the class of 2020. You've gone through something special, and that makes you guys very special.
So as you go forward from this moment, love more, dream bigger, be stronger, and never, ever, ever give up.